हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, कंटिन्यूशन ऑफ दिस प्रीवियस टॉपिक प्रीवियस क्लास टॉपिक थर्मल प्रॉपर्टीज दैट नाउ दिस पार्ट इज मेनली रिलेटेड टू द थर्मोडायनेमिक्स. यू आर गिवन एन इक्वल टू 5 मोल्स, गैस इज हीटेड, टेम्परेचर चेंजेस फ्रॉम 100 टू 120 इंक्रीज्ड, सो 20 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड इज द टेम्परेचर चेंज. व्हाट इज द चेंज इन इंटरनल एनर्जी दैट टोल्ड यू. इफ यू टेक द गैस इफ इट इन अ कंटेनर लाइक ए पिस्टन सिलेंडर सिस्टम एंड इफ यू सप्लाई द हीट, heat is absorbed by the gas molecules, converted into kinetic energy, and the kinetic energy increases, pressure increases, the piston outside pressure is atmospheric pressure, the piston moves upward directions, piston is moving means gas expanding means change in volume is there. Whenever there is a change in volume, work is done here due to the expansion of the gas. Whenever the gas expands, work is done, and gas expansion to the vacuum, that is called as a free expansion, there is no work done place. What against other pressure only expansion is there means work is done. So in this case piston moves upwards how long means inside as the volume increases the pressure decreases for this gases until inside pressure becomes equal to outside pressure, that means the pressure remains constant finally. So volume is whatever the work done in this case is nothing but equal to that pressure, constant pressure into change in volume. dW equal to PdV we take generally. P is the pressure which is constant equal to atmosphere pressure, P not I mentioning, or P I mentioned, or P only we generally take. dV indicates equal to V2 minus V1. So whenever the gas expands, there is a work done. So whatever the heat supplied, heat is a form of energy supplied, converted into two parts. One is to increase the kinetic energy of these air molecules. We are thinking of the ideal gases. Kinetic energy changes means temperature changes. For ideal gases, kinetic energy depends only on the temperature and also internal energy. Internal energy also changes. Internal energy is U. Internal energy you cannot measure. We can only measure the change in internal energy because it is proportional to change in temperature. So whatever heat supplied, dQ is a fractional change, or Q2 minus K1 heat supplied to the gas is converted into increase the internal energy and remaining part is converted to work done dW. This is called as the first law of thermodynamics. This is based on law of conservation of energy. Wherever dW is there, you can replace with PdV also. So this becomes equal to dU plus PdV. If the heat energy is constant, if the heat energy of the constant means if you take the gas in a enclosed system which is thermally isolated, heat cannot go inside and outside, like thermosphere is sealed. In such cases, the heat energy inside remains constant. So dQ is the change in heat energy becomes equal to zero. And dQ sign convention also important here. If internal energy increases, dU is positive. Heat energy is supplied to the gas. Supply to the gas means dQ is final minus initial increases. So heat supplied to the gas means plus you have to take. Internal energy increase means plus you have to take. Reverse case, heat is taken out, extracted, cooling. Heat dQ is minus you have to take. Next is work done. If the gas expands in this case, work is done is positive. V2 minus V1 is more. Or that means work is done by the gas, means expansion is taking place. dV is positive, work done is positive. If gas is compressed, work done is negative. Thermally isolated, dQ is, Q is constant, so dQ is zero you have to take up. That is called thermally isolated conditions if you take, that is called adiabatic process. Temperature changes. Temperature means dU can be changed. Without supplying heat also, dQ is zero also, dU equal to dW. It is work is done. Not only by expansions, if you take the cold coffee in the thermal flask, if you shake it, work is done, can be converted into change in internal energy. Next, this adiabatic process means dQ is constant. Isothermal process means temperature constant. In a case of isothermal constant, T constant, U constant, so D equal to zero. So dQ equal to dW is the case of isothermal process. But in any cases, heat energy generally, practically, heat energy converted into two parts, change in internal energy and amount of work done. So here dQ is related, total heat supplied is dQ. These are the parts only, part of the total heat supplied. So total heat supplied against constant pressure is related to the specific heats. Gas has the two kind of specific heats, molar apart from the molar and specific heat. Specific heat just mentioned per unit mass. Specific heat is defined as the amount of heat required to increase the temperature of the gas, 1 gram of a gas by 1 degree centigrade or 1 Kelvin. dQ by mdt if you take it as a small c. But in, for the gases we can keep the pressure constant, volume constant, we call as a Cv or Cp equal to dQ by mdt. So in this case, if the pressure is constant, Cp we take, volume constant, Cv we take. Per unit, specific word you are using means per unit mass you take, mass grams or kgs you have to take. Joule per kg per Kelvin is a unit. But if you are taking the molar heat capacity, if you take the mass in the gas in terms of the moles, you take the capital C or capital Cp is equals to dQ heat by ndT at use. Heat is required to increase the temperature of 1 mole of the gas by 1 degree centigrade. So what happens here is the total heat supplied is equal to dQ relation is against a constant pressure, that is Cp is equals to dq by n dt. But if the volume remains constant, the temperature changes. If you keep the container gas in a closed container from all directions, if you supply the heat, volume constant means what happens, it cannot expand, no work done. So whatever heat supplied is increasing only temperature or internal energy, we can say. That is related to at a constant volume. So the constant volume is corresponding to change in internal energy. So Cv equal to du by ndt, Cp equal to dq by ndt. Capital C, if you are taking, means what is the molar heat capacity. The relation between the molar and the specific heat capacity is small Cv or Cp is equals to capital Cp or Cv by gas constant, by molar molecular weight or molar mass. The relation between Cp Cv is called as Mayer's equation, that is a Cp minus Cv equal to capital R, if you take the molar heat capacities. If you take the specific heat capacity, Cp minus Cv equal to R, small r you have to take. The Cp by Cv, whether capital R smaller or is called as a ratio of the specific heat of the gases. Now come back to this problem. N is the number of moles that you are asked, is actually in the question at the specific heat mentioned, you please change that to molar heat capacities. So Cv, they asked, Cv is corresponding to constant volume in change in internal energy. Cv equal to du by ndt. Change in internal energy, they mentioned as a 200 joules, internal energy changes, and you are asked to find out Cv. Moles is 5. Substitute the values, 200 by 5 into change in temperature is 20 degrees centigrade. The result is 2 joule per mole per Kelvin. Next point. Next question is 141. Find the amount of heat required to convert 5 gram of ice from 0 degree centigrade to 40 degree centigrade. Whenever the ice is melting, any solids were melting process, during melting temperature remains constant. When temperature is constant, it's called the isothermal process. Melting of ice, boiling of water is corresponding to isothermal process. After while melting, once the starting melting starts, the temperature remains constant. The melting point of the ice is 0 degree centigrade at 1 atmosphere pressure. If the pressure increases, the melting point decreases. That is called as related to regelation. If you apply the pressure on the ice, because of its own weight also, the ice melts. Even that minus 10 degree centigrade also, ice is possible to melt. It is minus 10 degree centigrade. 0 degree centigrade is actually melting point at 1 atmosphere pressure. But if the pressure increases, the melting point decreases. That means at minus 10 also it can melt, convert into water. This water is at minus 10 degree centigrade. So that is supposed to be in the solid state. So if you remove the pressure, again this melted water converted back into ice. That is called as a regelation process. Next, first you have to melt the ice. The heat required to melt the ice, that is a change of the state from solid to liquid, is Q equal to mass into latent heat of ice. That's latent heat of ice is 80 calories per gram. That means if you want to melt 1 gram of the ice, how much heat you have to supply is 80 calories per each gram of, just per melting process. At a constant temperature, thermal temperature is constant, means isothermal process, but kinetic energy, that distance with the molecules increases, the potential energy changes in this case of melting of ice. Simply, this latent heat means hidden heat inside that, and water at ice at 0 degree centigrade and water at 0 degree centigrade. If you touch both, ice is more colder than water because ice absorbs extra heat, kind of latent heat, 80 calories per gram extra just to melt it, compared to that of water at a same 0 degree centigrade. Next, after melting of the ice, whatever the water form, that will be at 0 degree centigrade only. And again, you have to increase the temperature from 0 to 40 degree centigrade. The heat required is nothing but equal to mass into specific heat into change in temperature. Whenever the temperature changes, no, mass into specific heat into change in temperature in the same state will be there. State changes means temperature remains constant. So in this case, the change in mass, specific heat, change in temperature. Specific water is 1 gram per cc. If you want to, specific heat is heat joules, joule CGS, 1 calorie per gram per degree centigrade. 1 calorie per gram per degree centigrade is specific heat of water. For ice, they will give you the values. If you want to convert into joules, no, 1 calorie is equals to 4.2 joules. But calorie per gram, if you want to convert, 1 calorie per gram per degree centigrade will be 4200 joule per kg per Kelvin. That conversion you need to note from CGS to SI. So here two kind of heats we are taking. First you have to melt the ice, and then after melted ice increase its temperature. So heat supplied, heat required to melt the ice at 0 centigrade is mass and latent heat of ice. This is 80 calories per gram. That is fixed. And to increase the temperature of water from that melted ice 0 to 40 degree centigrade is changing temperature T2 minus T1 is 40 minus 0. 40 minus 0 is 40 only. To increase the temperature, the heat required is mass into specific heat of water. That is 1 into change in temperature. substitute the values, you will get the total heat is equals to Q1 plus Q2 is equals to 600 calories. If you want to convert in joules, no, just multiply with the 4.2 joules. But answer is asked in terms of the calories only. Sometimes they will give you the ice at minus 10 degree centigrade or negative values. You have to first increase the temperature to ice at 0 degree centigrade. Then you have to convert into water at whatever temperature you want. So in this case, you have to melt the ice, means the Q1 is equals to mass into specific heat of ice into change in temperature 0 to 10. This is nothing but equal to 0 minus of minus is 10 is nothing but equal to 10 degree centigrade you will get. Plus the melted ice, that ice structure converted into minus 10 to 0 degree centigrade ice only. Next case it has to melt, that is ML ice. Next converted into water, after melting this process, water will be then increase in temperature Q3 equal to mass, now it is in the water state, MS into delta T. Whatever temperature difference you want, that you can go for it. If you are going to boil it, then this will be at 100 degree centigrade. Water boils at 100 degree centigrade. Then Q3 for boiling cases required, Q4. This is boiling. Boiling is the process of conversion of the liquid state into gaseous state. Boiling of the water takes place 100 degree centigrade at 1 atmosphere pressure. Again, if the pressure increases, boiling point increases. For ice, increase of pressure decreases the melting point. For water, increase of pressure increases the boiling point. So that means in the pressure cooker, so cooking is easy because the pressure is more. So temperature increases to higher values, at high temperatures cooking becomes more easy. So in the again here in the water is converted into steam or vapor state. Again you have to take mass into latent heat of steam, you have to take or vapors. That value, latent heat of vapors, is 540 calories per gram. Here distance between the molecules should be very large, therefore latent heat of vaporization is very very high compared to that of latent heat of I, that is only 8 calories per gram. Steam and water boiling point 100 degree centigrade, the steam and 100 degree centigrade boiling water also same temperature will be there, but if you touch the steam it is more harmful than that of the boiling water because the steam has extra heat of 540 calories per every gram. We absorb more heat from the steam than compared to that of the boiling water, so steam is more dangerous. So if you want converting it from up to boiling and cases, you have to convert the other formula. You take melting of the increase in temperature of the ice means MST, melting of ice means ML, and increase in temperature of the water means MST, again boiling of the water means ML you have to use. Then total heat, you have to check the additions. Next graph also important corresponding to this, you check up the synopsis. Next 143, two spheres of densities D1 and D2, radius ratio is R1 and R2, specific heat ratio is also given. What is the ratio of the thermal capacities? Thermal capacities, specific heat is nothing but equal to, for solids or liquids or gases we talk about CV and CP specifically, but solids we don't talk CV, we imagine that volume is constant, almost CV only we have to use. So specific heat symbol generally taken as CRS equal to DQ by specific what means per unit mass into DT or TS. Heat required to increase the temperature of 1 gram of substance by 1 degree centigrade, or kelvins means SI units you have to use, kgs. And units will be joule per kg per kelvin, SI units I am getting. Otherwise calories you can use, calories actually practical unit of the heat energy. Specific heat of the substance is generally constant, we take specific heat of water is maximum, that is 1. For solids low specific heat, there means solids quickly heated, quickly cooled up. So water has a high specific heat, so it has advantages of the absorbing the heat in the radiators of the automobiles. They can hold the heat for long time, that is water. Graph also important please for the specific terms, but generally specific is exactly not constant, it changes. And specific definition in terms of the one calorie definition also important for the corresponding to the specific heat of water. This specific heat is independent of the mass, it is only constant for the given material at a given temperature. But mass into specific heat is called the thermal capacity. Thermal capacity is nothing but equal to mass into specific heat equal to dq by dt. dq by dt is nothing but equal to mass into specific heat. This is called the thermal capacity. Thermal capacity depends on the mass and also nature of the metal means specific heat. Same metal means we take always specific heat constants. This ratio of the specific heat thermal capacity they asked here. Thermal capacity also called as heat capacity. Bigger spheres, bigger mass, bigger spheres has more heat can absorb, therefore thermal capacity is more. Specific heat is independent of the size of the materials. And heat is always transmitted when you take two materials from high temperature to low temperature, not depending on the size, etc. It travels from high temperature to low temperature, the heat transmission. Next, two spheres of the density is given. What is thermal capacity? Thermal capacity is mass into specific heat. Mass equal to volume into density. Volume is 4 by 3 pi r cube sphere they mentioned. Spheres means volume is 4 by 3 pi r cube into density into specific heat. Ratio of the thermal capacity, if you are taking, you know, V1 by V2, D1 by D2, S1 by S2. Volume is in terms of the R cube, if you take R1 by R2 cube, D1 by D2, S1 by S2, such the values you will get the expression for the thermal capacity ratio is 1 by 16. Same problem will be asked as per unit volume. Whenever they mention unit volume, V1, V2, take it as a 1 unit. Or by V we have to use, thermal capacity by volume we need to use. Next question number 152. 20 gram of water at TD 1 degree 60 centigrade mixed with M2 another matter of mass of 60 grams of water at T2 degree centigrade. Find the final equilibrium temperature. This is called the method of mixers. The method of measuring with the heat is called as a calorimetry. Calorimetry is done by mixing the two different materials in a calorimeter. Calorimeter is a copper vessel generally used of honey conducting vessels. So when you are taking the two materials mixed up, these are hot materials mixed up. Then with the cold materials, what happens is the heat is transmitted from hot body to cold body. Hot means based on the temperature difference you are taking here. The heat is transmitted until both get the equilibrium final temperature same. So high temperature, first one is at 60, another one is at 20. Final equilibrium temperature, let us take it as a T3. T3 is the final temperature, equilibrium temperatures. And equilibrium temperature, that is related to the first of zeroth law of thermodynamics. If A, B, C. Equilibrium indicates same temperatures. At the same, every body above absolute zero produces the radiations. Even at I said minus 20 degrees centigrade also hot only produces the radiations. But only at absolute zero object is not emit radiations. So if the two objects are at same temperature means they are giving out the same heat and taking also same heat. Otherwise unequal temperature means hot body means more temperature body gives more heat and takes the less heat. Low temperature body also produces heat and radiates the heat, gives the heat more less than that it absorbs. That is a cold body until the temperature remains constant. So thermal equilibrium A and B are thermal equilibrium means temperature is same. It is also same. And temperature A and B are in thermal equilibrium with respect to each other. A and C are thermal equilibrium with respect to each other. Automatically indicates that B and C are thermal equilibrium with respect to each other. This gives the concept of temperature. This is a zeroth law of thermodynamics. In the method of mixer, so we mix the materials. The heat transmitted or given out or taken in is always equal to mass into specific heat into change in temperature. DQ, this also can be DQ and DT or delta you can use. So heat lost by the hot body. Heat lost by the hot body equal to heat gained by the cold body. These are other method of mixers or principle of calorimetry used to measure the heat. Heat lost by the hot body. Hot body heat lost or gained same formula, please MST. Mass into specific into change in temperature of the hot body. Temperature decreases. So T1 to final temperature T3. T1 minus T3. For second body, cold body temperature increases. So mass into specific heat of the second body into increase in temperature is the final temperature minus the initial temperature 20. Substitute the values. M1 is 20 grams, here also grams, no need to convert into kgs, in the ratios units will be cancelled. So just take 20. Specific heat of water is 1 gram per 1 calorie per gram per degree centigrade or 4200 if you take in S units, but not required here. That will be cancelled left and right side. So specific heat is cancelled here or else equal to 1 only. Mass into temperature difference 60 minus T3, 60 grams into T3 minus 20 degree centigrade. Calculate this, you will get the final equilibrium temperature as 30 degree centigrade. Some other problems are there. If you take the calorimeter, you have to find its mass. Take water, find its mass. Okay, and this will be at initial temperature, T1 degree centigrade. Water plus calorimeter. Then you are putting some solids, hot solid generally. Taking the spherical small spheres of the lead. This is at T2 degree centigrade. Drop it into this. The final equilibrium temperature is T3. Then heat lost by this solids ms into delta t. Delta t is corresponding to T2 minus T3. This is at high temperature and heat is equal to heat gained by this calorimeter plus water you have to use. And then you will have to find out whatever they ask you. Next question is 154. Gas absorbs, this is a thermodynamics problem, very important ones. Gas absorbs dq equal to 80 calories. Calories if it is given means you must convert into joules in these problems by multiplying with J. First law thermodynamics is dq equal to du plus dw. This is given in terms of the joules. If given directly you can use this. If they are given in calories you have to multiply with the J. J value is called the mechanical equivalent of E, w equal to J into Q. This J is nothing but equal to W by Q. joule, work units are always joules. Heat energy units can be joules, calories, ergs is CJ unit. So if you take in this, convert in calories into joules, we take the help of this J called as a mechanical equivalent of it, or joules constant. Units are joule per calories. In case if you take in SI units, this is also joule, this is also joule, then J is equals to 1, it has no units and no significance at all. In SI units, J is not at all used. But if a calorie is given only, you multiply the DQ with the J. You will get 336 joules, and work done by the gas expansion. By the gas means expansion, work done is 150 joules. Change in the internal energy is how much? The second law of thermodynamics, first law of thermodynamics is DQ equal to DU plus DW, and you are asked to find out DU. DU equal to DQ minus DW. DQ how much you got is equals to converting into joules, 336 minus what done is 150. The result is 186. Sign convention is important here. If you are taking the gas, expanding, work is done by the gas, work done is plus. Work is done on the gas, work done is minus. Heat is absorbed, internal energy increases, heat is increasing. So DQ is positive. If heat is given out, DQ is minus. If there is no exchange of the heat, DQ is zero. If the gas is not expanding, work done is zero. Next is the temperature is constant, then DU is zero. U is constant, so DU equal to zero. Internal energy increases, DU is positive, decreases, negative. Carefully the sign convention in chemistry, sign convention, some chemistry also it comes, thermodynamics equations, but sign convention is slightly different from our sign convention. You have to be careful with that. Next question is 166 one. For gas, the ratio of the specific capacities or molar heat capacities, gamma equal to given as 5/3. R is 2 calories per mole per Kelvin. R value in SI units, if you take note, its value is 8.31 joule per mole per Kelvin. But you are taking calories here, 2 calories. You have to remember these two values for the R. That is, R is the universal gas constant, same for all the gases. Generally, it depends for the ideal gas actually. Cp minus Cv, this is the difference of the two specific molar heat capacities, Cp minus Cv equal to capital R. And gamma is nothing but equal to Cp by Cv equal to 5/3 is given for us. You have to identify it is gas is monatomic, diatomic. No, you are asked to find out Cv, I think. Cp, Cv you are asked to find out. Sorry. You are asked to find out Cp and Cv. From this gamma is given, so divide throughout with Cv, Cp by Cv minus Cp by Cv, Cv by Cv is 1, R by Cv you will get. The Cp by Cv is gamma, gamma minus 1 equal to R by Cv. But you are given R by Cv, R value is given to you. So from this calculation you can get the expression for Cv. Once you get the Cv, you can put it back into this formula Cv value, Cp equal to Cv plus R, you will get the expression of pi. And you need to remember the gamma values, Cp, Cv values for monatomic gas, diatomic gas mainly, triatomic, polyatomic not required. You must know for the monatomic and diatomic gases. I will repeat those points later. Next, 167. In this, you have to identify whether it is monatomic or diatomic. If you take the monatomic gases like inert gases, helium, neon, argon, for them, this gamma is equals to 5/3, 1.67. This is the maximum. For diatomic gases, even air also, air is a mixture of multiple gases, but the diatomic dominates here. The resultant is diatomic. Only you take for the air is equals to 7/5, that is 1.4 you will get. And polyatomic, triatomic gases, the gamma is 4/3, but a small value variation will be there depending on that molecules are non-linear or linear molecules. Linear molecules along the straight line, and non-linear means not along the straight line. Depending on that, specific will be different. Depending on the modes of vibration also, do they have the how many degrees of freedom? Based on that also, that value of the gamma changes here. Diatomic and air, gamma is equal to 7/4, polyatomic, just right now we leave it. We are given that R by Cv equal to 0.67, but Cv minus Cv is equals to R. Cp minus Cv is equals to R, so divide throughout with Cv, Cv, Cv. What you get, this is nothing but equal to 1 you will have. Cp minus Cv, Cp minus Cv is nothing but equal to R by Cv you will have. This is nothing but equal to R by Cv, it means this whole thing is R by Cv. Cp minus Cv is equals to minus 1 is equals to R by Cv, that is equals to 0.67 you will have. and Cp by Cv is nothing but gamma, it is 1.67. 1.67 is for monatomic gases, 1.666 you will get, is nothing but equal to 5/3, that is for monatomic gases.